Hey guys, I got my buddy's F-150 in the shop. This is a 2012 model, and what I realized is I found out there's a common issue happening for you guys when you try to turn on your rear defogger. The light doesn't turn on, so you don't have the heated mirrors working, and the rear fogger no longer works anymore. So we're going to show you a quick little way to test the system to make sure the rest of the system is okay and that it's not something bigger. The first thing you want to do is check the obvious. So there are fuses in the passenger kick over here. You can remove this panel and you'll find a bunch of fuses that you have to test. After checking all the fuses in the interior, you want to check under the hood. So in the middle of the engine bay here up front, you can check all these fuses. That's where you want to start, because it could be something really simple where you have a blown fuse and then that's why the system's not working. Now I'd have to mention, you guys, we cannot confirm this is a fix for all trucks with this issue. We were checking the forums, trying to see if there's any truth to anything, and we were able to find one solution that seems to work to get the system to work again. So beware, try this at your own risk, but at least it might help you figure out what's going on. After doing some research, it seems that Ford has made the whole system in series. So it's kind of like your Christmas lights with incandescent bulbs. One bulb goes out, nothing else works. What's going on here is we have a rear window with a defogger. Okay, that's nothing new, but there is a sliding window that's power in the middle. You can see here, there's contacts over here. These might stop working, so you might have to take off this, figure out a way to reattach it, and clean off everything. So that's one thing that we checked. If the sensors that show that the sliding window is open when it's actually not, it will disable that whole system as stated over here. Now they're stating that because if you open the window, don't expect to use your defogger, but in this case, we have the window closed. Some people open and close it a bunch of times to help those fingers make contact. It may fix it, it may not. These are the fingers I'm referring to. So these guys will make contact over here. This window slides, they make contact with here, then the truck sees that the window is closed. Okay, I can use my defogger system. It seems to be okay. Over here, we'll show this over here later, there is a ground wire, and over here we have a hot wire and this thin gauge wire. From testing and tracing wires, we can verify that the wire on the passenger side is the hot line and this is the ground, because this also hooks up to the window and you follow it down and it just goes straight to chassis. The reason why I'm saying this is just for testing is I'm pretty sure we have to step this voltage down on this particular line. What we found is when the vehicle is turned on with the engine running, this will go up around 13 volts, whatever the charging system is giving us, and this line has nothing going on. So something has happened here in the window. And many people have reported that they've only been able to fix this by replacing the whole window assembly. Here in Canada, it's roughly about $1,200. Just depends on what area you're in. And the day is, this is expensive to change out. So what we found was some people with success have been able to jump the wires together. I put a fuse in line just in case, and I've been monitoring it. It doesn't get hot, probably because there's an open circuit in here, so this isn't getting that hot, but I can't verify. So I'm just trying to share with you guys what I'm finding. I will show you a product that will step this down to 5 volts. Metra actually uses a product to go from 12 volts to 5. What Metra has built this for are the older Ford premium sound systems, and this would help them avoid popping noises. This product would probably work perfect for our application. I've also seen people take apart a USB adapter that they would plug into their cigarette lighter that also steps it down to 5 volts. You can mess around with that. But if you want something with pigtails that's easy to wire up, look into this Metra part. Because what I think is happening, there's a resistor right here, but I think whatever happens in the window is also helping drop our voltage, because everyone's saying that it goes down to 5 volts. However, when I test this line, it's like 13 over here, I'll show you guys later, and then when I get past the resistor over into the connector, it only drops to 12, so we're probably not giving exactly what it needs to see. Okay, so I'm going to show you guys what we found. So on this side of the fuse, is 13.4 on this side. So obviously we're gonna get the exact same voltage going across. What I found interesting is because of that resistor, it's there for a reason. Down here, See, it's 12.8. So it is dropping a bit, but I don't think we're dropping it enough. But Ford has devised it a way that they want this line to drop. So I think there's something more built into these rear windows to help that voltage drop. That's why I'm suggesting that piece. Our jumper is in with our fuse. Let's go ahead and turn on the engine because that's the only time that this will work. And you can see that our light turns on again. Some people have reported that if you push it once, the light won't turn on, but the mirrors will still heat up. Wasn't able to confirm that, I tried it. Before we are at 23 degrees Celsius. We're gonna run this for a bit, and we're gonna let this heat up and verify that these mirrors are actually getting warmer. Well, you can actually slowly start to see a clem already. Good, yeah, it's actually climbing a lot faster than I thought. Ford did a good job on this system. So we've now verified that our mirrors are indeed heating up. Now when we ran the system and let it heat up, we got up to 34 degrees Celsius. So it's not quite there, but we have confirmed that it is working. If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way at all times you can always see if you just hop by the channel what our latest upload is. Plus with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself. We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration and informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section and it keeps applying it to different vehicles. Yeah.